most of the time, hair loss is usually not necessarily an independent problem. It's usually a symptom of another problem. So today I wanted to talk a little bit about hair. Our body treats hair, skin, and nails like accessories. Although skin is one of the largest organs of our body, when it comes to feeding it and nourishing it, it kind of comes secondary. That's why it's very important to make sure that we are taking care of ourselves. Most of the time, hair loss and skin issues are a result of some other problem. So the root of the problem is more important. That needs to get resolved before your hair loss will start getting back. So that's something I wanted you to just know off the bat from the beginning. And I'll get into some of the root reasons why hair loss might happen and how and what you can do to fix that. And everything that I'm going to discuss related to good hair health will be relevant to good skin health. And anything that's relevant to good hair health will also be relevant to good nails, because our hair and nails are made out of the same protein called keratin. So if you're going to do anything that helps your hair, it will help naturally your nails as well and your skin. There are different types of hair loss. There are more than four types, which are very common in women, but there are two very, very common ones that I'm going to talk about today, because those are the most relevant. More probably 80 to 90% of people who have hair loss have one of these two conditions. And the other ones, they have a completely different diagnosis and different treatment. And I don't want to get into that. It's also, although if you have one of those issues, it's very apparent and easily found out through going through to a doctor and, you know, getting a regular checkup. It's very easy to find the other ones. These two are kind of hard to diagnose and hard to find, so I'm going to talk about them, and like I said, they're the most common ones. So the main type, the most common type of hair loss is called telogen effluvium. That is when you suddenly see lots of hair falling. So you all of a sudden notice for a few weeks or a few months you've had a significant amount of hair falling, especially when you're combing your hair or you're going to the bathroom, you're seeing lots and lots of hair than normal. That's the most common type. And then there is another type which you don't necessarily see lots of hair falling, but you notice the thinning of your hair or the thinning of the part on your hair, on your scalp, and you can start visibly seeing a little bit of your scalp, which was never there. Or also, you notice that your ponytail is thinner than before. So this is a gradual hair loss. A lot of the times you don't even realize that you're losing hair over a long period of time until someone points at you and says, oh, you know what, you can see your scalp, or maybe, you know, you have a wider part on your head. So that is usually when people notice this. It is also a very common type of hair loss. It is also called androgenetic alopecia. The other name for it is female pattern hair loss. So these two are, they're different. Sometimes they can come together depending on what's happening in the body, but both of them have different reasons for happening, and both of them have different symptoms and different ways that you can maybe manage and treat them. Although I'm going to pick the most common ways to treat them, and we'll go from there.